everyone's having a good morning and doing well.
Good morning.
Miss Annette, how would you like to be greeted today?
How about air elbows?
Air elbows. Awesome job. All right, are you ready to start our morning?
I am. Are you ready to do our morning song?
I am.
Our friends know this song. They can help us sing it at
home. They do.
Good morning. I'm Jack.
And I'm Betty.
Let's get ready together for a great day. Sing along and move.
Good morning, let's get ready the brain smart way. Good morning, get ready to start the day.
Get your hands ready, shake, shake. Get your arms ready, stretch, stretch. Get your brain ready, cross, cross. Get your focus ready.
Good morning, let's get ready the brain smart way. Good morning, get ready to start the day.
Get your hands ready, shake, shake. Get your arms ready, stretch, stretch. Get your brain ready, cross, cross. Get your focus ready.
Good morning, let's get ready the brain smart way. Good morning, get ready to start the day.
Connect with a friend, shake, shake. Connect with a friend, clap, clap. Connect with a friend, hip, hip. Connect with a friend, hug.
Good morning, get ready to start the day. Get ready to start the day.
Hope everyone does a morning song today to get your brain working.
It can be any song that they want.
It can. Get your body moving.
Miss Casey.
Yeah.
Our friends are not back yet, so how about we wish them well?
That sounds like a great idea.
We wish you well, we wish you well, all through the day today, we wish you well.
Give them a big hug, mama kiss.
We wish you all well.
We wish they were back in the room.
I wish they were back in the room too. All right, do you want to do an I love you ritual this morning?
We can.
How about Georgie Porgy again?
They all have this card in their bag, so hopefully you guys are learning it. Show us your video of them learning it. That'd be awesome.
Yep, we haven't done this one in the classroom yet, so this is all of our first time doing it.
All right.
Georgie Porgy pudding pie gave his friends a big high five. With his friend he loved to play. With the gift of a smile he gave each day.
Good job.
We'll keep working on this one this week, and then maybe we can get it to a new one next week.
Yep, maybe next week's activity bag will be a new one.
So, I saw some of our job jars, pictures, so I'm hoping they all go good.
Yep, let us know how your jobs are going or what your jobs are, and if you forget to do them, just say, oops, I can try again tomorrow.
Same with the commitment boards. So let's see.
And we still don't have any celebrations on our board, so if you have something happy to celebrate, send it to us so we can put it on our board. Alright, are you ready for a small group today?
I am.
Today's small group is a magnet activity.
In their bag, they each had a popsicle stick with some magnets on it.
Miss Annette, can you tell us what we're doing?
We are going to go around the classroom, which we get ours on a tray. You go around your house, and we want to see what you guys can find that will stick to your magnets. I know we sent some bells home, right, Miss Casey?
And they were supposed to predict how many bells they thought could stick.
How many bells do you predict instead?
I'm going to predict two.
Two?
For each of my magnets on this side.
Okay.
Are you ready to see?
I am.
So we have four magnets all together.
Your prediction was correct.
That was correct.
If you did all the magnets, how many do you think will stick?
Maybe four, because I have four magnets. My prediction was correct again, so have your grown-ups write down your prediction and tell us if your prediction was right or if it was wrong.
I wonder what else they could find around their house.
I don't know. What are some things that we found?
I found a potato smasher in our kitchen, and our kids like to play with this. So, if I stick it, the potato smasher is heavier than the magnet.
So what does that mean?
Do you think it'd still stick?
It might.
Do you think if I stick it on and turn it upside down?
Yep, it looks like it is.
It is sticking.
What if you hold the popsicle stick, Miss Annette?
Let's try. Oh, it will not stay. If I do it this way, the potato measure is too heavy. So, what else do you think we can try?
Let's see, we have a quarter here. Miss Annette, how much is a quarter worth?
It is 25 cents.
Uh-oh, this one doesn't stick. Try a quarter at your house and see if you can get it to stick.
I have a paper clip. It sticks pretty well, but it is lightweight.
We have a magnetile, which everyone loves to play with in our classroom. Very well. If I hold it like this, maybe. It's heavier than the popsicle stick.
I wonder if we put more magnets on our sticks if it'd help.
That might be a good idea.
So maybe that's something you guys can try at home. Find something that has more magnets.
All right, Miss Annette, do you want to do one more today?
One more. I have a key, but do you think the key is going to stick? It is not magnetic. So, let's see what you guys can find around your house.
Your parents or grown-ups can make a chart of what you found, and you can write yes or no next to it and say if it sticks or if it doesn't stick. Right, that's all for small group today, but don't forget, today at 2:15, we are having a Zoom with Rory from the Works to work on sound. We hope everyone can join us. All right, better shake, little snake.